Hello and welcome back to our second video on IPSE GO. Today we are building a Steam cycle and we are going on New Projects and choose our library. And then we're going to enter the name and click on OK. So first what we need is going to be to draw our cycle. So we will need a boiler. Boiler will connect to a turbine and a connector. And afterwards, we are also going to need a generator and a pump. It might happen that you're not sure where to connect and which terminal. So you can just go to the little question mark, which will open our documentation, where you can find more individual information about each component. So now we are just missing our pump. And now we're going to connect them with streams. You can see you don't always have to be exactly on the terminal. If you're missing it just a little, IPSE GO will automatically connect the stream for you. We will need to add a composition, and instead of doing it separately, we're going into Add Global under Objects. We're going to call it Water and Steam. And just as the last time, we're going to set all the other components to zero, so this way we only have pure water. So now we're going to select all of our streams and going under Objects to Set References, and we will add our water and steam to the composition. So let's try to calculate now. As you can see, IPSE GO is giving us an input failure and is telling us that there are missing parameters, which are shown here. So what we can do now is we either put all the parameters into our components individually, or we go under Data and load defaults, and it's going to ask if it's okay to override existing values. We're going to click on yes, and as you're going to see now, all the parameters have been filled automatically for us, which is usually a good way to start your calculations with and change them afterwards. So if we calculate now, it should start with no input failures. And if we're going to open the protocol, it is showing us that we have system undefined, degree of freedom is 4, and we need to change following variables to reduce the degree of freedom. So we are going to change the pressure at the inlet of the turbine to 41 bars and the temperature to 440 degrees. Also, we are going to define the kilowatts at the generator. We're going to set it at 1800 kilowatts and the pressure at the outlet of the turbine. This way we have covered all of our 4 variables. So before we are going to calculate now, we are going to assume that we want to know our cycle efficiency. So we're going to add a data frame under Objects with 1 row and 3 columns. and we're going to type efficiency of the steam cycle into our first cell. And now we are going to enter a formula by writing equal to, which will give us automatically a way to add the variables of the generator and divided by the heat input of the boiler, which equals to the cycle efficiency. And you can see now that it's automatically showing you the green calculation sign, which means that you have to calculate before it's going to show you the results. And in the last cell, we're just going to enter the dimension of the calculation. And if we press F5, it's going to calculate, and you can see that our cycle efficiency is at 0.29. Now, before we are finished with this example, I'm going to show you a cool new way to download your IPSE GO project onto your desktop if you want to use it as an IPSEpro project or file. You simply go to projects, make sure to save it first, and press on download. And that's it. Thank you for listening, and see you in the next tutorial.